Allahu Akbar. I have pronounced La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and with this statement I am guaranteed Jannah. What? Who told you that? MashaAllah, people make big statements here, MashaAllah. So why does my sin matter if my end will still be paradise? And you know what? People like this, they will quote the hadith, من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. That's true. That's an authentic hadith. But there are two other hadith, أخي. You have to study them with this hadith. Put them, the three together. من قال لا إله إلا الله خالصا من قلبه. So the first one is the tongue, right? Second hadith said that لا إله إلا الله should come from the heart. And what's the meaning of La ilaha illallah? La ilaha illallah is La ilaha illallah. What's wrong with you? It's La ilaha illallah. Does it need explanation? MashaAllah. People wrote books on the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Messengers all came to explain La ilaha illallah. And we take it for granted. La ilaha illallah means there is no God worthy of worship except the only one true God. That's Allah. So you start with the negative. You say, La ilah. There is no God. Oh my God, how dare you say this? You mean there is no God worthy of worship. But in fact, there are many gods. Some people until today, they worship the cow. Some people worship fire. Some people worship people. So when you say there is no God, you mean there is no God worthy of worship. Because all these gods are false. So when you say La ilaha illallah, La ma'buda bihaq illallah. Now the question is, when you hear this, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. What does this mean? It means Allahu Akbar, akhi. So no. It means Allah is greater than everything you are doing. If you really understand La ilaha illallah, nobody should be worthy of worship except Allah. It's time to worship Him. It means come to the masjid. And if Allahu Akbar four times is not enough, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah two times is not enough, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah two times is not enough, Hayya ala salah. It's explicit. Come to prayer. This is the time. If you truly say La ilaha illallah, it's time to worship Him. This is the time. This is the worship that's due now. Leave everything else. Even if you are reading the Quran. If this is not enough, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala motivates you. Hayya ala al-falah. Those who will come will be successful. Do you want to be successful? All the other people who do not respond, they're not going to pass. They're going to fail. You see? So we need to understand the meaning of Allah. So first of all, it's the tongue, right? Second, اعتقادٌ في القلب. It has to be deeply rooted in your heart. And then عملٌ بالجوارح. As you said, actions by the limbs. And this is why, look at the last hadith. من كان آخر كلامه من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. He whose last statement is لا إله إلا الله, who will make it to Jannah. And I tell you this, Wallahi, you will never be able to say La ilaha illallah at the moment of death if you have not been living all your life to apply the requirements of La ilaha illallah. Never ever. There is a whole book written by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah about the people at the time of death. What they say is what they have been living for all their life. A short story. The three brothers in one of the countries that I lived for some years. When they made tawbah and they came back to Allah, they were four, but one of them was lost. This is why they made tawbah. They used to go to the desert and date some girls and spend time with them. And one time they ran out of food. And one of them went to the nearest town to bring food and he was late. So they went to see why he's late. So when they went to the highway, they found him in his car and the car's burning and he can't get out. So they rush to him to help him. And listen, these people pray 5 times a day. Because some people, they have a disconnect between their hearts and their actions. When you ask them, what's this? They say, we pray to Allah, we'll get the reward, and we commit sins, and we'll get punished for this. MashaAllah, are you two persons? Are you double-faced? Now, when they rushed to him, he was burning in the car, and the music was on in the car. And there is a famous singer in the Arab world. She was saying, هَلْ رَأَ الْحُبُّ سُكَارَ مِثْلَنَا. And he was repeating after her, even he was burning, he was dying. Have the drunk people seen love like us? And he was repeating like that after her. So they came to him, like, no. They wanted to rush to the car, they can, because the car was burning. They can't even go to him. So they said, like, you know, أخي, say la ilaha illallah. And he's looking at them, and he's repeating what the singer is saying. هَلْ رَأَ الْحُبُّ سُكَارَ مِثْلَنَا. And he kept repeating and repeating, like, you know, say la ilaha illallah. He said, وَخْرْ عَنِّي, leave me alone. And he kept saying what he was saying. And he couldn't say it. Why? Because Allah said this in Surah Ibrahim. يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ الظَّالِمِينَ وَيَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah said, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ. Who will support you at that moment when you are dying to say la ilaha illallah? بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ أَيْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, when you are living this worldly life. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ, in the grave, when you are asked the three questions. Allah said, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا نُطُ الَّذِينَ أَسْلَمُوا. So the believers need support from Allah at the moment of death and in the grave. They can't say it unless they have been living for it. And if you need another story, read Surah Yunus. Surah number 10, ayat number 90 and down. It tells you the moment how the Pharaoh died. He drowned. And while he's drowning, this is the man who used to say, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. He made a claim, I am your Lord, the Most High. Mr. Lord, you're dying now. You're drowning. Save yourself. Do something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَمَّا أَدْرَكَهُ الْغَرَقُ. When he was sure that he's drowning, no way out, he's in the middle of the sea. What did he say? He was arrogant at the moment of death. It's easy to say la ilaha illallah, dear brothers and sisters, but Allah said, وَيُضُلُّ اللَّهُ الظَّالِمِينَ. Oppressors and tyrants like the Pharaoh will never be able to say la ilaha illallah at the moment of death. And if you don't say la ilaha illallah at the moment of death, you will never see Jannah. It's not as you think, it's not that easy. He said, آمَنْتُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا الَّذِي آمَنَتْ بِهِ بَنُوا إِسْرَائِيلَ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. 14 words. It's easier to say la ilaha illallah, but he will never be able to say it. And Jibreel alayhi salam says to our beloved Prophet sallam, لَوْ تَرَانِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَخُذُ مِنْ طِينِ الْبَحْرِ وَأَضَعُهُ فِي فَمِ فِرْعَوْنِ حَتَّى لَيَنْتَقْ بِالشَّهَادَةِ. He said, Prophet of Allah, at that moment, when the Pharaoh was drowning, I used to bring the mud from the bottom of the sea and block the mouth of the Pharaoh. I was afraid that he might say la ilaha illallah and Allah would forgive him and have mercy on him. Because whomever Allah hates, Jibreel hates, the angels hate, and people hate.